Hey, what's going on, dudes? My name is TDC, and welcome back to my Minecraft world. Hopefully you guys are having a fantastic day today. We're going back to the fantastic thing already. That didn't take long, but yeah, so welcome back, man. So today, we don't have a plan, really. I wanted to do some building on something that I've been working on. We'll go up there and take a look at this, and I'll kind of explain to you what this is going to be. But we need to do some preparation work in order to get this done. So we're going to have to go do some stuff today. But first, I would like to reintroduce you to Hermules. Hermules is back. Hi, kitty. What are you doing? Kitty's come to say hello. But also, we have Palmules and Momules. So I had to breed a horse that was actually, he's not bad. He doesn't have a whole lot of health, and he's not the fastest, but he's got a pretty decent jump, and I don't know, he's not bad. So I bred this one with this donkey over here. This donkey really sucks, but it's like the only one that I could find. But it has a lot of health, but the jump sucks on it, and it's not very fast at all. So yeah, I don't know, Hermules is not the best, but he is back, so it's kind of nice to have a donkey. He helps me or a mule, I should say. He helps me get stuff around. So he's got a lot of help, and he's not incredibly fast, but he's not slow either by any means. So that's kind of nice. We're going to take him around here a little bit. We'll go ride on him for a little while. Trying to think if there's anything else that I should show. I don't think there's too much. But sorry, my dog's chewing on a... We got a package not too long ago that had this like cardboard tube in it. And for whatever reason, he's really taking a liking to it, and he's chewing on it behind me right now. So if you hear some munching in the background, that's what that is. I should talk about this. I got everything all cleared up, man. All these chests and everything that were here, I got them all put away in the storage area down there. A bunch of the bulk storage I moved over to the Guardian, which is the ship, by the way. And then I also kind of worked on adding a little bit of smaller... minor detail stuff around here, adding some fences in some places. It's kind of like really clarifying the paths, so there's still a little bit more over here that I would like to do. I'd like to add some stuff in here and kind of make this like a little courtyard spot. And I also added this too, so this is kind of like a little, I guess, what are these things called, like gondolas or something. I just kind of wanted like a main feature on top of this this bridge here, so just kind of, I don't know, it looks cool. Not bad. But that's what we got today, so far, that I've done over here. I haven't really touched anything else. I cleared that chest like I said I was going to, put some wheat down there, and then also somebody said to plant some wheat around the place down there. I think that'd be probably a pretty cool idea, so we may try to do that at some point. They'll probably just do it off camera and I'll show you guys next time, but that might be kind of cool to add a little bit more variety in plant life. So thanks for the person that left a comment on that. I appreciate it. I didn't think of that. I used to use weed as kind of a decorative thing back in the day, but I haven't used it in a long time. So so let's head up here. I'm gonna show you what else I have been working on, and the project that we need to start the resources on. So I've made a house up here. It's not finished by any means. Hopefully the donkey don't fall off and kill himself, but I've had a couple people leave a comment for user request for a windmill. Now, I think we're going to put it up here. I don't know if a windmill should really be placed up on top of a mountain. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but I think this is going to be a cool spot to see it. So we should be able to see it from just about everywhere down there. And the windmill itself is going to go right here. So what we need to collect today is some sheep, because all our sheep died, because we're going to need a lot of wool. And I think this would be, I don't know, a good day to do it. So we're going to try to run around and see if we can collect some sheep. But I don't know, like the inside is okay. I'm going to need to kind of touch up some of the finer detail stuff. But this is also going to be our pathway up to, you got to kind of go through the windmill house. And this is up here to the farm. Now, I want to talk a little bit about this before, because I know a lot of you remember that we had an issue with the, I think it was like 1.3... release or pre-release or something like that, but all my mobs despawned. So I did go into creative mode and I spawned in a bunch of horses, because all the horses that were in this area, can we get in here please, despawned, and I had a ton of horses up here that I had plans for, especially once we start getting really building in the kingdom. To do like some stables and things like that. So I just used a spawn egg and spawned in a bunch of horses. So a lot of you guys said a long time ago with the mob issue that we lost a bunch of stuff. Oh, look, we got another donkey too. I didn't realize we had one. Y'all said just go ahead and cheat him back in. It's no big deal. So that's what I did. And if any of you feel cheated or disgruntled about that, oh well. but yeah, so we got our horses back, no big deal. And I don't know, this is gonna be cool for like later on in the world when we get the stables up and going. I want to spend a lot of time on the stables. I think that'd be kind of a really neat thing. So yeah, what else? I think that's really about it as far as building and stuff goes off camera. What are you doing, Hermules? You were so close to the edge. You were in trouble. but yeah, so let's go see. I need to make some leads so we can make some get some sheep over here. Now, I'm not going to cheat the sheep in. That's just kind of cheaty. Sheep we can go find. Horses, on the other hand, are a little bit difficult, especially in amplified terrain. So I'm not too worried about the sheep. I think we can do that. But the horses and stuff, I couldn't. Man, I couldn't. I can't. I can't even. So, let's go see. Now, I'm starting to get the hang of my storage room and remember where things are, which is nice, especially since I spent so much time reorganizing and moving things around. So I can tell you right now that all our goodies are on right, like right here. We got diamonds, iron, and I think coal up here in the top one. We got redstone and lapis, I believe, in one of these two. So I know the general area. We got plant life in these. And then over here, we have like nether stuff. Lighting stuff, glowstone. I think we got some sand in this one, glass and different decorative blocks, and then we have like mycelium, gravel, podzol, dirt, grass blocks. There's a podzol, grass blocks, dirt. We got coarse dirt in here. There's the gravel and there's the mycelium, nether blocks. Oh, the guardian blocks too. I put in some of these over here so we'd have some. Sand and red sand. Red sand we actually haven't used too much of. Then the glass and all that kind of good stuff. And then back here, we have all our different kind of stone stuff. So cobble on that side, all the new blocks on this side. The polished versions here, which I don't think we really need that much storage for this stuff, but it's there. And we got all our wood on this side. Now I split up the birch and jungle wood, which are the two woods that I use the least. So they're gonna kind of share these three chests, but how I have this organized is we got wooden the actually wood blocks in the bottom or the log blocks, and then we have the planks in the middle, and then slabs and stairs in the top, and I guess doors if you want to count this last little slot. But yeah, that's pretty much it, man. We've got a bunch of stuff. There's all my craftables, and we still got some empty chests here, so that's pretty good. But yeah, so everything is all organized, nice and neat, and I know the general direction. Now that I'm actually going to be using my storage system, I can start memorizing where things go and where they are. So, give me a minute, I'm going to get some leads together, I'm going to sleep the night off, and we'll be right back. So, we've got 9 leads, I think that should be enough. We're going to kind of head through the castle, we're going to go out that way. We haven't really explored too much over there, and then also while we're out, I'm going to work on kind of lighting some of the immediate area up. That way, when we actually start getting over here to build, we won't have to really worry about doing all that, and the mobs won't be as ferocious. It should be pretty good, but today's going to be just kind of a chill episode. I didn't really have a plan. We're just going to kind of chill and talk and gather some sheep, and hopefully we can get them all over here with no problems. We can kind of go from there, but yeah, look how dark all this stuff is over here. After I built all this, I just kind of, I left it, and I haven't really done too much with it, so we'll work on kind of lighting some of this area up and see what's going on. But we're going to talk games today, man. I have an addiction, and I feel like now is the time to bring it up and talk to you guys about what's going on and what we can do about it. So recently my brother has started playing a game that I have actually played a little bit before on the channel, and we're going to be doing some stuff together, and we're just really just going to be playing, and I'm going to be recording some stuff that we do and just kind of some of the fun. What is going on? I'm using my other mouse about the game with Terra, which is an MMO, And I'm using my mouse that's got all my hotkeys on it, and it does this weird double click thing. So if you see, I've actually got two mouse hooked up. So here's one right here, and then on the other side I have this one, which may sound kind of weird, but actually let's go ahead and switch these out right now while we're playing Minecraft. The only reason I had that one turned on, or that one plugged in, oh, this mouse is sensitive. This is my gaming mouse, like my Minecraft mouse. Much different, but it doesn't do the double click thing. Or did it? I don't know. But yeah, so Terra, it's an addiction, man. I am finally, because I've had the game forever, okay? But I have never gotten to a max level. Okay, this mouse is way too sensitive, and it's kind of making me sick right now. So instead of going in and changing some of the settings, we are just going to use my MMO mouse and not get motion sick. So I'm not seeing any sheep. But yeah, so we just started playing. I've been playing for a long time, but I've never had a max level character in that game. And that's what we've been doing. There's like a double XP event going on right now, so it kind of helps you like level your stuff up or level your people up. What am I thinking? 9 sheep. Let's just take 2 and breed a whole bunch of them. I think that's going to be the smarter idea, if we can even find any. But yeah, so we've been playing that game a lot here recently. I think I've put in... which is kind of bad, because the days, to be honest, I kind of needed it. The days that I've had off, I've been working like crazy amounts here recently. Texas has been like in monsoon season. For those of you who haven't heard, Texas has been getting some crazy weather, and it's driving me crazy. Because when it rains or the weather sucks at work, it pretty much puts everything on hold. I guess I should say when there's lightning storms, it puts everything on hold. And we can't really get a whole lot done, and it just kind of keeps piling up and piling up and piling up, that sort of thing. But normally in Texas, we only get like maybe like one day or like one good thunderstorm, really a year, to be honest. We don't, here in like the Dallas-Fort Worth area, we don't get a whole lot of thunderstorms, which is kind of sad because I really like thunderstorms. So this week has been awesome, and then it sucks at the same time. I don't even know where I'm at now. We're going to be so lost. So I think we kind of came up through that way, right? But there's like no life out here, man. What is the deal? I'm not seeing anything. Interesting. But yeah, so it's been storming like almost every night, like thunderstorms, man. I have not seen thunderstorms like this in years, probably. Hold on. All right, sorry about that. I had a phone call I had to take real quick. But yeah, so I haven't seen storms like this in, I think, ever. I have never seen as bad weather in Texas as I've been seeing here recently. And it's kind of crazy, but I love storms. Like, I love thunderstorms. Anytime it's like thunderstorming or lightning and stuff outside, I'll go outside and sit on the patio and watch them if I'm not getting like soaked with rain or anything like that. So it's kind of cool to see, but work-wise, it really kind of sucks. So I just got to kind of deal with it. I thought those were creepers up there. Man, it's so dark in here. There's some really cool terrain, though. But I am totally lost now. So we're just kind of, we're hiking, and I'm wasting all my torches. But yeah, so going back to the whole Terra thing, I've been playing a lot of that because I haven't really been focused on YouTube, because I just kind of needed a break from work and a break from stressing myself out over YouTube videos, which I know you guys are cool with that. And I just feel, I don't want you guys to feel like I'm intentionally letting you guys down by not doing videos as often. Last week was really crazy, so I was working a whole lot and to get a whole lot of video work done. Ooh, roses. I don't think we have any roses. Why do they do that? Why does it flash to the peony? Can anybody tell me? But in my free time, especially last week and this weekend a little bit, I have been playing Terra with them, and I've been having a blast with it. So I think I'm going to start recording it a little bit, and I'd like to try to get some other people playing it, because it's definitely a really, really fun group game. And so hopefully I can persuade maybe some of the hyperminers or somebody to play with it. I know Armitage has been on my case to play it for a while because I invited him to play when I did the last couple of videos that I did of Terra on my channel. And then I ended up kind of stopping because I didn't have a whole lot of people to play with, or I just didn't have the time, I guess, to put into it because it was around Christmas time, which is really busy for work. But he was on my case for a little bit about playing Terra, so maybe I can talk him into dusting it off and getting back into it. I don't know if he still plays or not, but it'd be interesting to see. But it's a really, really fun game. It's free to play. There's a lot of really fun stuff that you can do. And like I said, there's been like this event thing going on this weekend where it's like double XP. You get like twice the amount of XP that you normally would, so you can level up. Sheep! We're going to take you. I don't know where we're going to take you, but we're going to take you. We'll see what happens. So we've been playing a lot of that, trying to get our levels up on our characters pretty quick, because most of the in-game content, I think, in all MMOs come at like your max level and stuff like that. So it's not something I've ever done before, especially in this game, even though I've been playing it for a long time. That is a lot of lava. There's cows. I need sheep, though. All right, sheep. Come this way. Come on. Oh, you stuck? There you go. There you go, buddy. Are you good? Okay, we're good. But it's, I don't know, man. It's just, I have an addiction to it. It's almost, I guess, I don't know if you guys are into the MMO thing and if y'all consider Minecraft an MMO. I guess it can kind of be classified as an MMO, but to me, Minecraft is just like a game in its own, a genre in itself. Especially the way I play it, because I'm just, I build, man. That's what I do. But I can't build in Terra, unfortunately. That'd be so cool, man. Come on, dude. Let's go tree hopping. But, it's just been a lot of fun. So, I don't know if you guys play MMOs or not, but you guys should, I maybe can relate to the addiction problem. Because it's just constantly like, oh, I gotta get this in the next level. I've gotta learn these new skills. I gotta get these combos down. At least in Terra. Terra is like a very, very interesting. It's like a true action combat game. So it's basically like a hack and slash MMO, which is a lot of fun, at least in my opinion, because I cannot do the point and click thing like a World of Warcraft or anything like that. It drives me crazy beyond belief. So the hack and slash aspect of Terra Online is, or I guess Fate of Iran now is a, hey, we found our way home. We can sleep. So come on, dude. But I think that's why I like it so much, is because it's really more of a hack and slash type game. It's not so much of a... are you stuck? Man, I don't have any blocks. Take some of these dirt blocks. And I don't know, if you guys are interested in playing it, you should definitely go check it out because it is free to play. What happened here? Why? If I do that, can you come now? Come on. There we go. It's getting dark and dangerous out here. We gotta go. But yeah, if you guys are interested in playing, make sure to stay tuned to my channel this week, and I will do, I'm planning on doing some other videos and stuff on Terra if I can get around to finding the time to record with them. I think we're supposed to play a little bit later on tonight, but we'll see if that actually happens. And I will show how to explain, or I guess I will show how to download it. You can actually download it on Steam now, which is really handy. So if you got Steam and you know your way around Steam, you can just go to Steam and download it there. So come on, sheep, let's run. Are you going to keep up? I think he's going to keep up. Hurrah! well, we found one sheep. I think there might be another sheep down by the docks, but I think that was one of the ones. Oh, hi, guy. That despawned. And we lost because we had some wild sheep just running around here for a little while, but... Oh, no. Let's sleep real quick and then go capture this guy again. Maybe we can deal with just one sheep and find another one kind of close around here. But I don't know. Alright. Are there sheep down here? I don't see any sheep down there. But going back to the addiction thing, it's really hard to kind of like bring myself to Minecraft. Is not that like vanilla Minecraft, this world anyway, is not that hard to get back into. Like once I start playing in here, I'm like, oh yeah, why did I ever stop playing? Why isn't this just all I play? Bunny rabbit, That's not a sheep. But some of the other games and stuff, like modded Minecraft, is just not really doing it for me right now. I'm going to give it a little while. I'll try to record, but if I'm just not really into it, I don't want to subject you guys to being forced to watch me play a game that I'm just not really into. I think it really brings the fun factor down, the fun level, and makes it kind of uninteresting for everybody. So I'm going to wait till I'm back into the groove of modded and get back into it. So I'm having some issues with the Resident Rise 3 pack right now, which is what the Hypermind mod sauce or Hypermind modded server is running. So we'll just kind of have to play it by ear and see what happens. But I think hopefully you guys won't mind. The first couple of videos of Terra I put out on my channel had a really good response, actually, which surprised me. And it seems like we've got quite a few people interested in the whole series. So maybe you guys will be interested in doing some stuff over there, and I can kind of do the best of both worlds, my Minecraft world. Hey, look, we got some leads in there. We got some wheat. But I don't know. We'll just kind of have to play by ear and see what happens. So we need one more sheep. One more sheep. But I guess the question of the day for you guys, for those of you who stuck around this long and haven't been bored by the Terra talk, what games are y'all playing? What games are you addicted to right now? Because that is definitely it for me. Like, I really am, I wouldn't say addicted, but it's just like the only game that I can really concentrate on. And I'm really enjoying it. Like, I'm having a 100% genuine grand swell time playing that game. Even when I'm just playing by myself, there's something oddly relaxing about playing an MMO and just going and grinding little quests and things like that. I was talking to my brother about that while we were playing, and it's just, it's so relaxing. You just throw on some music and hey, there he is. He is still here. Okay, come on, guy. Let us go to the farm with a sheep pit. But yeah, it's just, it's bizarre. And Minecraft kind of does the same thing to me. Like, building and mining and doing different things like that in this game is just, it's really relaxing. And it's just enjoyable to do. And it's the same thing with Terra, man. It's just, it's a blast to play. So I highly recommend that game to anybody who's interested in having another game to play. Like, if you're stuck playing one game, don't do that to yourself. Go play some other games, get some inspiration, because I have definitely got even a lot of inspiration for this series from playing Terra, because some of the scenery and like the backdrops and things like that in that game are incredibly impressive. Like, the builds and the structures in that game, I guess you could say, are just beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And some of the stuff I definitely want to mimic in this area, because there's a lot of sets and like the areas that you go to that remind me a lot of what we got going on here in this world. So I want to try to kind of mimic some of that stuff, and I'll post some, if you follow me on Twitter, I'm going to try to post some screenshots that I have taken in Terra, so you can go check them out there. And that's going to be kind of some of the stuff that we got going on in this world for future builds and the stuff like that. So I don't know, it's going to be fun, man. It's going to be a lot of fun. Can you grow? Will this grow you? I thought wheat was supposed to grow you. Yeah, it is. Look. Grow, sheep! You're not growing. You are a fatty. You ate a whole stack of wheat and didn't grow at all. Goodness. I guess growing animals need their protein. Wait, hold on. I was having an issue with this, too. I was growing Hermules over there. Okay, see, he is grown now. It's a visual glitch. They just don't grow for whatever reason. So let's see, we can't breed y'all right now. Okay, so we'll put that back. But I think that's gonna be it for today. Sorry it wasn't a whole lot of building. We really didn't get a whole lot done, but I need wool to get some of this stuff done up here. Actually, hold on, let's go see how, I don't know, I need to check the time on the video, because if we got enough time, maybe we can come back and we can finish this build up real quick and just kind of batten it up, all except for the actual windmill up there. So give me 1 second. I'll be right back, and we'll see if we can get some building done. All right, so we actually don't have enough time to get any building done. And I just realized, checking the footage to check the time on the episode, that there was no sound. Game sound, anyway. It should be fixed in this clip. I had been changing some stuff in DxTory so I could do some group recording stuff, and I guess I had changed one of the things on there for recording game sound, and I'm sorry about that. So, the rest of this video, the earlier portions of this video, don't have any kind of game sound, so I apologize for that, and it'll be fixed. It won't happen again, Rabbit, I promise. Okay? No, you don't believe me. He doesn't believe me. Sad rabbit. But yeah, so anyways, I will see you guys next episode. We're gonna get some done on the windmill. Even if I don't have enough wool yet, we will get up there and we will finish doing that up there. Wait, up there? We'll just get that done up there and we'll wait to see if we got enough wool to actually do the whole windmill. But and then I'll actually post the comments of who said to build the windmill. So if you've got another build idea, leave it down below in a comment and we'll eventually get around to it. So you can add your name to the Hall of Builders over there, the Builders Hall, the Donators Hall, whatever you want to call it, Everybody Hall. And we can kind of go from there. But hopefully you enjoyed today's episode. Sorry about the no sound thing. That really, it was an accident. I know that can be kind of annoying, but hopefully you guys enjoyed the commentary. My strong, powerful voice, and, I don't know. Anyways, hit that like button for me down below. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in the next episode of my Minecraft world for some more building goodness. So, talk to you guys later, alright? Thanks for watching. Peace.